Beloved intercessor, today we want to declare that we are in this together. Yes, we are in this together. And there is a powerful lesson in 1 Samuel chapter 30. But first I want to declare this together with you. Whether we are strong or weak, the people that are fast or those who are slower, those who are energetic or those who are tired, those who are well known and those who are anonymous, we are together. We have the same heredity in Jesus Christ. In 1 Samuel 30, it says that David took all the flocks and herds after he won the battle. In other words, he got a fortune, and people were declaring, "This is David's plunder." And then there were 200 men who had been too exhausted to follow him. So when they reach, they come back from the battle with the army, and they see those 200 men who were too tired. The Bible says in verse 22, all the evil men and troublemakers among David's followers, I think they are anywhere. They can be in any church, in any group. The evil people, troublemakers, they begin to complain, and they said, because these 200 weak people did not go out with us, we will not share with them the plunder. We have them in any society. These are rather divisive people. Technically right, they are often right, but without compassion. They use the church bylaws, their own rights, even the Bible they can use, but they are divisive. They don't build up the body of Christ. And David rebuked them. And this is the powerful reply that I want to share with you here. "No, my brothers," he said, "you must not do that with what the Lord has given us." Notice David honors the Lord. "He has protected us and delivered into our hands the raiding party that came against us." Again, giving the glory to God for the victory and the protection. "Who will listen to what you say? The share of the man who stayed with the supplies is to be the same as that of him who went down to the battle." This is a powerful principle in Christianity. Strong sheep, weak sheep. Those who are more spiritual Christians, more immature Christians. We are together in this. That's why God put us in the same church, in the same family of Christ. Then verse 25, "David made this a statute and ordinance for Israel from that day to this." It is so important, people of God, that we embrace this principle, stop the fights, and we'll be able to help each other. I don't know in which camp are you, in which of these two camps, the strong ones that went with David, or the exhausted that stayed. But I declare in the name of the Lord to any exhausted soldier, anyone that is so weary in the battle, I declare this in the name of the Lord. We inherit the blessing of God, the heredity of the gospel together. May the Lord encourage you with his words and bless you.